As of June 16th of 2024, there are currently 48 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which for the first time in several weeks is the exact same figure as measured last week. One of these erupting volcanoes is Italy's famed Mount Stromboli, which since it has been near continuously erupting for the last 5,000 years has been nicknamed the Lighthouse of the Mediterranean, as its orange glow is often visible from a fair distance. Stromboli generally produces a moderate-sized explosion about once every 10 to 20 minutes, which throws bombs of lava into the air and emits moderate amounts of ash in what is termed a Strombolian eruption. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Italy, for the first time in 2 months, Mount Etna erupted, sending bombs of lava several dozen meters above its Forogang crater. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, a notable increase in seismic activity along with the occurrence of volcanic tremor was detected at the Slamet Volcano, suggesting that it may erupt in the near future. And, in what is this week's top story, a fresh flow of lava generated by Iceland's erupting Reykjanes volcano flowed onto and covered a major road. Lava had been largely flowing towards the north-northwest for much of the past 2 weeks, causing the lava field to grow to as much as 25 meters or 82 feet thick in that sector. Hugging topography, this slowly caused molten rock to advance closer and closer to Iceland Road 43, which goes straight north from the Svartsengi geothermal power plant and the Blue Lagoon. On June 8th, the strongest such flow of lava since day one of the eruption occurred, causing the lava field to broaden and advance 450 meters or 1,476 feet. As a result, 345 meters of this road were covered in lava, blocking it off for everyone. Since a section of this flow, when combined with prior flows, overtopped an 8-meter mark, part of it began flowing over the top of and beyond the lava wall. Luckily, the motion of this overflow has since ceased due to the hard work of construction crews. More lava is likely to flow in the same direction at around a rate of 5 to 8 cubic meters per second, potentially leading to more overflows of the existing lava wall in the next several weeks. Meanwhile, in Italy, a certain viewer of mine is quite happy with the fact that the very day before he visits Mount Etna, it began a new eruption. This eruption began around 11 a.m. local time on June 14th from the stratovolcano's Vorogreen crater. While fairly weak in nature, lava was ejected several dozen, perhaps even 100 or so meters into the air in a Strombolian manner, originating from a small point source within the crater. This caused small fragments of molten rock to be flung outwards in a 250 meter radius, subsequently tumbling down a portion of Etna's upper slopes. So, will this currently weak activity soon turn into a major paroxysm, where kilometer-high lava fountains, pyroclastic flows, strong ash emissions, and even major flank lava flows are possible? While this is technically all possible, I see no immediate indication that any of this will occur, although there is an increased chance for this whenever eruptive activity does take place. And, in Indonesia, the last 9 months have shown a continued increase in activity at the 11,243-foot-tall Slamet volcano. A further increase in earthquakes beneath the volcano has occurred twice this year, once beginning on May 9th and once again around June 5th. More than 20 volcanic earthquakes are occurring every day now, and this is occurring alongside the detection of volcanic tremor. When you combine this with the continued detection of ground deformation and the fact that strong degassing began at Slamet in the last week, it indicates a high likelihood of a small to medium-sized explosive eruption soon occurring. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on June 15th of 2024.